Get better, faster answers by reading what's in front of you. Hi, everyone. Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. I will absolutely admit this is a bit of a rant slash vent on my part because I see it so often. However, addressing that can make life better for you. Let's start with a question that I got not that long ago. Question: how do I solve this problem, sir, please? A problem has been detected and Windows has been shut down to prevent damage to your computer. Unmountable boot volume. If this is the first time you've seen the stop error screen, restart your computer. If this screen appears again, follow these steps, etc. So, that was the entire question. I did not respond for reasons that will become apparent. We've all seen these types of error messages. These messages essentially tell you exactly what to do next. My assistant's proposed response to this person was to, I'd follow the steps described in the error message. I mean, that seems obvious, right? So why didn't the person asking the question do exactly that? I have no idea. But I see this so often that I have to talk about it. I have to encourage you to essentially slow down, take a breath, read what's in front of you. Another great example, on the Ask Leo Ask a Question page, which is at askleo.com/ask, there is a disclaimer, some instructions at the beginning of the comment box. It reads, read this article. What information should I provide when asking for help? The number one reason for not getting an answer is not giving me enough information to go on. Be complete. That means at least Windows version, version of other software involved, make, model, and configuration of computer, detailed steps to reproduce the problem, exact error messages. As you can see, the original question included none of that. And it continues to frustrate me that so many questions that I get asked with that disclaimer, those instructions right in front of the box, ignore those instructions completely. They end up asking me the moral equivalent of, it doesn't work, and I'm left with nothing to go on. That's often why I end up not responding. Sometimes I do, depends on how much time I've got, depends on how I'm feeling, to be honest, because this is one of those things that can get very frustrating very quickly. And I gotta say, it's about more than just error messages. Error messages would help so much. They really would. Even a screenshot of the error messages. And I've got ways to get screenshots to me after you ask your initial question. The problem is that people don't. They don't give me the information I need. Something as simple as the version of Windows, or something as simple as the program that they were running, or the steps that they took. Take a breath. Slow down. Sit back, read what's in front of you, and think, please, what information can I provide that will help whomever, that's not just about me, but whomever, to help me out? Now, I get, there are absolutely some cases where it is totally not obvious what to do or where to look. For example, Outlook, Microsoft's Outlook.com. If you take a look in the menu bar, there are these silly three dots. If you don't know what those mean, you're kind of lost, right? I mean, it's not clear what features or functionality are available in the menu bar that precedes it. If you don't know that that is a continuation icon, it's called an ellipsis, three dots. And if you click on it, you get more menu items to choose from. Not obvious until you learn what the ellipsis means. At the other end of the spectrum, I had to go back to the old Facebook sign-in page for this because they've since changed it and made it actually a little bit more obtuse. But on the old Facebook sign-up page, here it is on the screen. Now, I have two questions for you. Is Facebook going to charge for access someday? What should you do if you can't log in? The answers to both of those questions are right there on the page. And yet, people don't see them. They don't read them. Maybe they don't believe them. I don't know. But they keep asking those questions of other people, including myself, that they could have answered themselves simply by reading what's in front of them. So, like I said, it's my rant because I see it so often, but it's really not about me per se. This is about going out and getting help from other people, providing information that will allow them to help you, or potentially not even needing to get help because the solution was in front of you the entire time. So, my practical advice in all of these situations, when you run into, say, a frustrating situation or a frustrating error message or just filling out a web form asking for help, take a moment. Breathe. I know whatever you're facing is probably very frustrating and you want to get it solved now. Just slow down. Read the information on the screen carefully. Honestly, that's all we're asking you to do. And unfortunately, this is where many people fail. Take the time to understand, to make sure you can understand what it's saying as best you can. Again, I understand not all of these messages are clear, but many of them are. They're worth reading. And if you can't understand or you don't understand what the words or what the message is trying to tell you, that's fine because that becomes great information for whomever you're asking your question of. If you get to say, you know, hey, the screen said this verbatim, word for word, and yet I don't know what that means, great, that's an opportunity for, say, me to explain what's going on. It also tells me a little bit about how I should explain things for you. And would allow us to move on to, hopefully, a solution. Ultimately, do those things. Take a moment, read, understand, and then take your next steps accordingly. I hope that helps. I really do. It's my frustration, but it's your opportunity to not need answers or get better answers more quickly. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/15818. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.